Reports from the Campbell County Sheriff's Department are that a man working with James Madison's shop, a Caravel logging crew, sustained serious head injuries just after 9 o'clock this morning. Calvin Doherty, age 62, was injured when a tree he was cutting kicked back, injuring Doherty in the head. First responders brought the logger out of a heavily wooded area by the way of a four-wheeler. The accident site is on Interstate 75 near Sharps Lane and Tackett Loop. That's close to the I-75 bridge at Vasper. LifeStar landed at the Caravel ball field to transport the man to UT Medical Center. His condition is not known at airtime. June Forstner is the new vice mayor on the Jacksboro Board of Mayor and Aldermen. She was unanimously approved last night during the regular monthly meeting of the board. Ray Green previously served as vice mayor for Jacksboro. In other business conducted during last night's meeting, the board approved the advertising of bids for the purchase of a fire truck and two sets of turnout gear for the fire department. The board also approved the donation to the Jacksboro Cemetery Committee and voted to apply for a COPS grant to possibly hire an additional police officer. It was a big night for the 2013 senior class of Campbell County High School last night. Countless awards and scholarships were presented, totaling thousands and thousands of dollars. In fact, 66 Campbell County High School seniors have their tuition completely paid for at Roane State, Walter State, or Pellissippi Community Colleges. This is the first year that the state of Tennessee recognizes students as graduating with honors and graduating with distinction. A student graduates with honors if he or she meets certain benchmark scores on the ACT. A student graduates with honors if he or she meets certain benchmark scores on the ACT, and a student must make at least 18 on the English portion, a 21 in reading, a 22 in mathematics, and a 24 in science to qualify. Those graduating with honors are Jamie Allen, Josh Bullman, A.J. Cutsinger, Larissa Douglas, Lindsay Hudson, Brady Kennedy, Gates McCarty, Kara McLean, and Autumn Reynolds. A student graduates with distinction if certain requirements are met, including a 31 or higher composite score on the ACT, a score of 3 or higher on 2 separate advanced placement exams, and 12 or more hours of dual enrollment at a community college or technical school. Those graduating with distinction are Haley Atkins, Robert Atkins, Ashley Binge, Weston Brown, Emily Burge, Miranda Carmony, Molly Cowart, Madison Griffin, Tara Griffith, Rachel Harris, Chelsea King, Amber McKillop, Ethan Miller, Ethan Morton, Dalton Phillips, Kevin Ruin, Ryan Rutter, Gunner St. John, and Stephanie Wilson. Some very special Campbell High seniors qualify to graduate with honors and distinction. They are Sam Arnold, Tanner Carson, Adrienne Evans, Helen Guerin, Lauren Heatherly, Brandon Lee, Nathan Orrick, Sarah O'Rourke, and Ethan Simpson. The Campbell County Prom is this Saturday night. That means it's coming up. This year, the prom is going to be held from 5 to 9 at the Women's Basketball Hall of Fame in Knoxville. The florist business has been booming with the prom on the way. Ideal Florist says they've been very busy and have probably already made at least 50 corsages, and Bucky at Cobblestone Florist tells WLAF that they have already finished about 35. And we're expecting soaking rains for our weekend weather. A pleasant, mild, but breezy day wraps up the work week today. However, a rainy weekend is ahead. Expect soaking rains with locally heavy rainfall at times tomorrow through early Monday. As much as 3 inches of rain could be on the way and on the ground by the time we start the new week, prompting real flooding. The usual suspect areas will have standing water at times over the weekend, so be sure to drive carefully and watch for the standing water. That's a look at the news. Back with the press release from the Sheriff's Department in just a moment. And it looks like 10 people have been booked into the county jail in the past 24 hours. Scarlett Lauren Bowman, age 20, of Rose Hill Drive, La Follette, for possession of a Schedule 2 and Schedule 3 controlled substance. 30-year-old Robert David Brown of Butcher Lane in Lake City for violation of parole. Robin A. Ford, 41, of West Chestnut Street, La Follette, on a capias. 18-year-old Michael Allen Matlock of Briceville on a capias bench warrant. Randall McFlesh, 21, listed as homeless in Jacksboro, on a capias bench warrant. 42-year-old Barbara Ellen Taylor of Main Street in Jacksboro for public intoxication and resisting arrest. Everett M. Walden, 48, of 912 East Chestnut Street, La Follette, for habitual motor vehicle offender, second offense of driving on a revoked or suspended license, violation of the registration law, and violation of the Tennessee financial law. Dustin Lee Wallace, 25, of Sutton Road, La Follette, was held for Anderson County. 25-year-old Tabitha Lee Wilson of Glade Springs Road, La Follette, for driving while revoked, violation of a traffic control device, violation of the Tennessee financial law, and violation of the registration law. And last today, Mary Woods, age 33, of Commerce Street in Jellicoe, for aggravated criminal trespassing, unlawful carrying or possessing a weapon, and reckless endangerment. And we thank you for being with us for this Friday for our end of the week edition of the news. Hope you have a great, happy, safe weekend, and join us back here again on Monday.
Let's give us some tickets out there. Mm.
We sing happy birthday to you, and may all your dreams come true.
Happy, happy birthday.
Oh,
this is your birthday song.
Oh,
celebration all night long.
Oh,
may all you.
Hey, Big Josh with you once again on this Friday afternoon. We're looking at our birthday and anniversary club. Our birthday and anniversary club, brought to you by WLAF and Eastside Pizza and Deli in the Food Lion Shopping Center. Birthdays today, Alec Longmire turned 7 years old. Happy birthday to you, Alec. And Carolyn Gibson. We're not sure how old Carolyn is, and she won't tell us, so we're not going to say. Happy birthday, Carolyn. And we got triplets here celebrating their first birthday. How about that? Chase Knox and Quinn Wilson. Happy birthday to you all on your first birthday. And Melvin Brandenburg is the second. Melvin Brandenburg the second, I better get that in there, is 36 years old today. Yesterday, Ashley Ogg celebrated number 25. Happy birthday, Ashley. And back on Saturday, we had twins. Mahala and Cora Shelton turned 8 years old. Happy birthday to you all. And our anniversaries today, yesterday, Lois and Pawnee Ridner celebrated an anniversary. Happy anniversary to Pawnee and Lois. And Wednesday, James and Jennifer Paul celebrated 18 years. Happy anniversary to Jennifer and James. And today, Gene and Charles Chapman, 44 years. And we want to congratulate our winners. Our birthday winner, Donnie McNeely, celebrated yesterday. Congratulations to Donnie. And we have David and Jamie Wilson that is our anniversary winners this week. Congratulations to you all. You all have won a birthday and an anniversary dinner for two at Eastside Pizza and Deli in the Food Lion Shopping Center. I'm out of time. See you Monday, good Lord willing.
Never